Amanda Drury is with us. She's here this week at CNBC Global Headquarters with her take. Mandy, great to see you. We're fortunate to have you this week. Can you give us a sense of what it looks like on the ground right now in
China?
Yeah,
sure, Maria. You know, it's really interesting because I remember only about 6 weeks ago when the market in China was up about 90% year to date. In fact, the best performing index around the world year to date. A lot of people were saying, you know, it really feels like the heady, frenzied bubble days back in 2007 when everybody was wanting to get on the bandwagon and throw their money into the stock market, regardless of what the valuation was and what the fundamentals of the market were. Essentially, mini correction, Maria. And a lot of people are obviously trying to work out, is this the start of a bigger correction to come? Is the bubble bursting? What does it mean for the rest of the world? They're all really salient questions. And of course, no one's going to know what exactly is going to happen in the future. And I can't tell you because I'm not really a market strategist either. But what I can tell you is people are saying this is not necessarily a bad thing because you cannot have a market that goes up so fast and so far without some kind of correction. Because if we did just let this keep on going up, the danger is that you might actually have a massive pop of the bubble like, of course, we already saw. And the authorities in China are very, very aware of this. They want to take some heat out of the market as well.
Right. You know, Mandy, I guess one of the big topics of conversation on this side of the world is the transition that China is going through, transitioning from an export-led economy to a consumer-driven economy. We really haven't seen that consumption in the country, the American consumer remaining the more important consumer when it comes to eating up the products there. So how fast do you think that transition is moving? Do you think that you're seeing a better than expected, quicker than expected move from an export-led economy to a consumer-led economy?
Well, it's sure that the crisis has sped this this process up, Maria, because obviously before the crisis set in, that was, you know, priority number one for the Chinese government. They essentially did want to beef up domestic demand and not be so vulnerable to external forces by being so reliant, essentially, on their export economy. But, you know, with the crisis and external demand collapsing in certain ways, obviously they've had to, you know, switch the engine of growth over to domestic demand. And the stimulus package in China, and trust me, they've got trillions of dollars in their reserves at their disposal to stimulate this economy. The stimulus package has certainly helped beef up domestic demand. So, you know, it's been a sort of a transition process that maybe was sped up by the fact that we had this global crisis.
Yep. All right. And that stimulus package, a lot of people talking about that it's working so much better than actually the United States' stimulus package. But we should point out that, of course, it is a much bigger portion of the GDP in China relative to the United States' stimulus package. Mandy, great to talk with you. Thanks so much.